Hello, YouTubers. It is 12/9/2014. Okay, we have a report here from December 7, 2014. Protesters vow to continue fight to scrap controversial secrecy law. Okay, daily data news coming at you. Weeping Willow 2. Tokyo, protesters against a controversial secrecy law that was enacted exactly a year ago vowed Saturday to continue their fight to have it scrapped amid concern the legislation undermines the public's right to know. With the law that will toughen penalties on leakers of state secrets set to take effect Wednesday. About 1,600 people gathered in Tokyo's Hibiya Park and later marched in the Ginza district, while around 700 demonstrators took to the streets in Nagoya. Lawyer Yuichi Kaido, an organizer of the Tokyo rally, said civic groups must remain vigilant as the secrecy law enters into force to ensure activities continue to be monitored at military bases and nuclear power plants in Japan. We will not cower and will keep fighting for the abolition of the law, Kaido said. The law provides for imprisonment of up to 10 years for leaking information related to defense, foreign policy, counterespionage, and counterterrorism that is deemed to cause considerable damage to Japan's national security. Oh, I like that umbrella. Everything's thrown up underneath that umbrella of national security. You know, hell, they use that shit here in the United States. Shinji Suzuki, a 22-year-old university student who joined the protest, said he is worried that only a small number of young people took part. I'd like to tell my friends what I experienced at an occasion like this and continue the opposition movement, he said. In Nagoya, Takahiko, 68, said he will not give up on seeking the repeal of the legislation. We should not make society dark by allowing the suppression of people's right to know and freedom of speech, he said. Naomi Nonogaki, 53, said the secrecy law should be discussed as a major issue in the upcoming December 14 House of Representatives election. If Hiroshima lawyer Hajime Kawaguchi told a rally that when he requested the disclosure of information related to self-defense forces activities, only documents with sections blacked out were released. When the law takes effect, even these documents cannot be released, making it impossible for us to verify the SDF's activities, he said. It would be a dangerous situation because irresponsible decisions can be made with regard to SDF dispatches overseas. And Fukuoka lawyer Akiko Maruyama pointed out that Japanese embassies could limit the disclosure of information concerning public safety in conflict areas, citing diplomatic confidentiality. The overseas activities of Japanese civic groups may be scaled down, she said. Okay, y'all have a good one. Carol.